fuel can. Like Boozer says, I hear a bunk calling my name. Should do it. Hey, Cope, this man I'm tracking down, who'd he kill?
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them was a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
Hold on, I never did finish burning out this nesting zone.
Bounty. Don't let him go. This'll do. Let's see.
Yeah. make something out of this. Use everything.
Cut it out!
I need this.
Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
All right, what have we got? You're mine now.
There he is! Silver helmet, red gas tank. That's him.
Oh shit! The hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, and just ride out like you just... chop it.
Let him get away, Deke.
Thank you.
hands on that. Not a fan of it myself, if you want to know the truth. Give Drifters a bad name. But what if you'd shot Manny? You know, who'd fix my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You are a Copeland's toadies! You little bitch! That's what you are! You little bitch!
Cope, it's done. Got him.
You
mark down these coordinates and send your man out here.
You hear me?
Is he alive?
Hey, Drifter.
Yeah, he's alive. But I won't promise you how long he's gonna stay. That way, Deacon out.
You tell him, Drifter. You tell him I said your ghost grew himself.
St. John. Copeland. I haven't seen Boozer in a few days. He used to do runs for me, is all. I know you ride with him. Tried to radio him, but can't seem to reach him. When you see him, you tell him to swing by and say hello to Copeland.
Man, no. No, I wouldn't about you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Hey, Dad. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Think. It means a lot to me.
Take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out. Boozer, you there? There's just a couple-
Calling a checkup on you.
Yeah, D, come here.
You hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we're riding north, just like you said.
Ah, I hope so. God, I miss you on the road.
Just working on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out.
I gotta burn him out. I gotta make it safer to ride.
Bounty. Yeah, I can always use this. I need these. Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? Which way? Maybe in one of these.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? You're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase him down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
Thank you.
Okay. That's interesting.
Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
You're a researcher. What the hell are they doing out here? Gotta go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet. If they see me, I'm dead. Throw a rock, that ought to distract them. You're a researcher. What the hell are they doing out here? Gotta go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, Myers, be quiet.
Sir? How the hell do I know? We'll bug out when the docks finished.
We got enough fuel to get back. Quill all we're hell back today.
Fuel's the least of our problems. We're on the ground. Just stay focused.
What are we doing out here anyway?
What you told? Shit.
Doing all right?
Oh, I'm getting sick. Can't afford to lose the duty credits.
You okay?
Seems like a lot of freaks around the grotto.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 5 to 6.
Just stop! Yeah, I don't want we're entering trouble. A quarantined area.
Okay, that ought to distract them.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
Sleeping with babies, Sarah.
And I asked if you were going in.
Can't be.
Say I was.
And these subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah.
Station of shrubs. They
I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit, but not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was FUBAR from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Secret caves? Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn. Stay low, stay low. I gotta keep to the bushes.
Hear that?
Yeah. Getting hungry?
Time now.
Anyone else hear that? What was that? How much longer do you think we got?
How the hell do I know? We'll bug out when the docks finished.
You there? Booze man, come back.
Okay.
Good night. Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Death.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard. I went into their house and they.
Wait, you went into the RLC? What the?
Just listen to me. I heard the radio. They're talking about a man named O'Brien.
Big dog.
Boozer, I'm not. I'm just. Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out. Scram.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope. The cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit radio-free organ.
Topping off. Alvarez, I'm not gonna leave you to the freaks.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Black helicopters have been spotted in the skies. You might have seen them. Heard them. Thought you were losing your mind. But you're not. They're real. And they're proof that I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them. Caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said, they've been lying in wait all this time so they can crawl up out of their holes and reclaim this world.
I haven't too good a day, Cope, to let your shit spoil it for me. Nest. Gotta be right around here. Another one. Yeah, time to light it up. Use this. these nests. Hello, squatter camp. Sons of bitches have been setting up ambushes around here, yeah? Murderers and thieves, and I can't let any of them escape. First one down, now the rest of you.
That's the last of them.
What do you think now, huh? Somebody shoots back. How do you like that? Finally, Jesus.
Damn it!
right, you son of a bitch!
Gotta finish this.
Is that it?
Is that all you got? Yeah, that's what I thought. Next time you set up an ambush, don't pick on the wrong guy.
All right, where did you hide your bunker, huh? I know you got one.
This'll do.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. But last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds, or rippers, or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive. The strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's something called law and order or a thing of the past. What the hell are you talking about?
But yeah, you got a point about force being the only thing that matters now. Force and a lot of goddamn ammo. Bunker.
Yes.
Here it is. Looks like they marked it up good. Got some papers, notes on crafting. Yeah. What the hell is that sound? Micro recorder. Hello.
Hey, how many runs has this
been?
You're
only up there just with the
doctor. God, I'm tired. Yeah, I know, right? I'm right there with you. It's too goddamn many. Lost count. Hey, you check the manifest? Where's the next load going,
feeling a little under the weather.
It's over at the Iron Butte Ranch. They started a new dig site just outside the resort there.
That must have made those rich assholes happy. I wonder how much a house on the ninth hole is worth now that it backs up to a mass grave, huh?
Yeah, I know, right? What the hell?
What are they doing? Oh,
Jesus! Break! Break!
Oh, no! We're gonna hit him! No!
I guess you boys never made it back to fill that manifest, did you? Well, didn't matter. There was a hell of a lot more where they came from. Thank you. That should be it.
Yeah.
Let's see. It should work.
Hey.
Last time I was on the road, and it will be the last time.
You looking for something? Yeah, it is hard to find fuel out there. Cool. Need anything else? Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. Good choice, man. Good choice. This should last you for a while. I'll wrap that up for you. Cool. Need anything else? Look me up if you need anything else.
I was working at the Farewell Elementary School the day your
mom died.
You can imagine, right? I mean, I was teaching letters to a bunch of students.
That's it.
We use the word teaching very loosely here. When this kid comes in late.
What do you need?
Damon.
He didn't look right. Sort of odd. Next thing I know, he's biting the kid next to him, then another, and then another.
Oh.
I gotta help.
Hey.
We got the kids.
How's it going?
Took the others to the nurse, but...
Hey! Nice.
That's all I got for now.
I swear, within a half hour, less, the kids were snapping at each other. Within an hour, the whole school was infected.
What's up?
No one knew what to do. Hell.
Nice. Now that's what I'm talking about. Okay. Later, man. I didn't think I'd see you around so much.
Just looking.
Deacon, you can keep an eye on that gas tank. The one with the custom paint job you've been asking about.
Hey, Manny.
You feeling any better?
Back to work.
It's getting dark.